What makes a good deed good? Is it the motivation or the outcome or a mixture of both? It's no secret that people who aren't Christians are producing a lot of positive change in the world, sometimes in a far greater measure than the Christians, but they're doing it often for very different motivations. So the question is, does motivation matter when it comes to deeds? Let's say I post something on social media in support of a charity. Now, because of my post, people will hear about the charity, maybe they'll give more money, and then more people will get help from it. But what if I told you that the reason that I posted was because I was virtue signaling and trying to show the world that I'm this philanthropic, caring person, even when I'm really not? The post was about as far as I was gonna get into it. Is that still a good deed despite my selfish motivation? Or does my selfish motivation cancel out the rightness of the action? Now, it's true that people can absolutely benefit from deeds that come from selfish motivations. Laws that benefit and lift up people who are hurting or broken can be truly helpful, even if they came from a selfish motivation, like a politician just trying to get reelected. But when the motivation is wrong, the chances that the good outcome will be in some way corrupted increase either in the short term or the long term. When our human selfishness or greed or desire for reward enter the picture, it's pretty certain that our right actions will be compromised. Motivation matters because it's the filter that we use to decide when and how much we should act. The Christian worldview says that the only way to have pure motives that are not spoiled by our own selfishness are to have acts that flow out of love and gratitude to God. St. Paul says, "Whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God." And so in the Christian worldview, in order for something to be good, it has to be done specifically for this motivation. If you're not doing something for God, you're ultimately doing it for yourself, which makes it selfish. Once the self enters the picture, the lens for what is right and good for other people gets clouded. So if there really is a God, as the Christians say there is, who created everything, including morality, then he's gonna be the best resource for what is good and right and best for all. In the Bible, it says in the book of Hebrews, it is impossible to please God without faith. Anyone who wants to come to God must believe that he exists. So if the Christian worldview is true, then it will only be people who believe in God, who have put their faith in Jesus, who can actually live their lives out of that truth. Only Christians will be able to act from that motivation of gratitude to Jesus for restoring the broken relationship between them and God. Now, if you're not a Christian, I can understand why this would come across as maybe intolerant or offensive, but that's actually not the issue that I think you should be most upset about. Because if everything I'm saying is true, the issue you should be mad about is this: if Christians alone have the capacity to have the right motivation to do something, then why don't they do it? That's what we're gonna talk about next week.